We are moments away from face-off in game two for Great Britain against Estonia. GB go into this game on Ice Hockey UK TV in association with McDonald's, fresh from a 4-1 victory over the host Croatia last night. What a great performance that was. What will unravel today? Well, Lithuania topped the table early on. They've now won 2 out of 2 after their victory over Romania. Let's find out what happened. We're going to have the analysis and or the post-match reaction. But first, the highlights with Seth Bennett and Andy French.
Game two of the Ice Hockey World Championships here in Zagreb. GB looking for back-to-back victories over an Estonian side they beat by 2-1 12 months ago in Eindhoven. That was a gritty game where they had to grind out the result. But for Great Britain, they need a little more than that if they're to build on their performance against Croatia last night. Chance to try and clear the puck out of the zone. It goes high. Cowley is the man after it. Tries to pull this one back. Could break towards. Peacock scores! GB on the board after just 25 seconds. Peacock finds the net. High fives all round as Great Britain are in the lead. And Estonia caught cold. His second goal of the tournament. As this one floats down the ice, Cowley does the donkey work. And there's Peacock. And Koitmaar is beaten on the first shot of the game. Farmer then goes after it, shields back to Farmer, who lets it go round to Dowd. Farmer makes his way to the net. It's with Dowd, right wing corner. O'Connor picks it up, lets this one go. Hits the man out in front, who is Ozipov, and now Estonia will break away again. Dowd, great skating to get back. O'Connor, under pressure, will clear away again, and now Robert Dowd will take it down the left-hand side. Just steps around his man, that was beautiful. To Cowley, scores! Wonderful play from Robert Dowd. Great skill, a feather pass for Russ Cowley, and the Coventry Blaze man fires high. Over the catching glove, and Great Britain lead here by 2-0.
Robert Dowd skated past that guy with such ease there, as if he wasn't even there. No disrespect, but it was watching it again here on the replay. I don't know if the Estonian mistimed his move or thought he was closer than what he was, but great goal from Russell Cowley. He's sitting there now, 1-1. And it's good 7 minutes to go in the first period, and GB get that second goal and get a little bit of breathing space.
Seventh international goal for Russ Cowley. We've got under 7 minutes to go. Ruba for Estonia in the right wing corner, works it around. Lars Salu sends this one to the net. They score! A little tip out in front, and Great Britain find themselves pegged back here. Petrov was the man that drove hard, and I think he got the final touch. It's Great Britain 2, Estonia 1.
That Rudolf, every time he goes on, is a danger, isn't he? And he's calculating a lot of ice time. It'll be interesting to see what he does cover by the end of the game. It's a nice little tip. Is it Myers on the guy? And he just gets the tip there, and Bayons didn't really have a chance for that, to be fair.
The puck was all along the ice. Salu had a good shot, and then it was deflected from low to high, from the top of the crease into the top corner. But Great Britain have it with Weaver. Little head fake, pumps the puck into some space. No icing will be called as Peacock chases this one down. Lays it off for Russell Cowley. Left wing corner. The two goal scorers combining for a moment. Now Tate looking to put this one home. It scores! Back door, second of the game for Russell Cowley. Tate with a moment of magic in the production of that goal. And Cowley from the top of the paint slides it over the line, and GB lead by 3-1. And the fans turn and they jump as it's Poznan time here in Zagreb.
Coventry combination there, 55 seconds into the second period, and we get that two goal cushion again that I think it will hopefully settle us down a little bit. And nice goal, well taken, back door, well worked by Ashley Tate. Calm, put the puck across, and there was Russell Cowley to put the puck in the net.
Here is a chance. Quick shot, what a save by Ben Bounds. Tibertsev with a shot, but Bounds spread eagle to make the save. That was a one-timer that required lightning reactions from the Cardiff Devils, man.
Great save from Ben Bounds.
Just looking at what Estonia are doing there, there's certainly being, there's a chance now for Petrov over the middle, he scores! Squibs through Ben Bounds, and a breakaway chance taken by Estonia. And GB's lead now is cut to just one. It's Great Britain 3, Estonia 1. Petrov the scorer.
That'll lift the Estonian team again there. It's brought them right back into this game. And I'd say as well, against the flow of play, we were creating a lot of opportunities there, but just that there was a long pass again out of their own defensive zone, and he was gone. And I thought Bounds actually had it at first, and I think he went through, was it the five hole?
And now it's a chance to skate away for Osipov. Falls over, the shot will come from deep. There's a good block in front, and there's a man that goes down. And he's not moving on the ice here. And it's David Phillips who's lying there. And he looks in some pain, does the Manchester Storm defenseman. He's getting some attention out there on the ice from the medical staff. But the arena goes very, very quiet here. We get a chance to look at the replay. It looked like his left leg just folded underneath him. And it's his left leg that he's not moving as he goes off the ice here. Bounds doubled over right now. The puck, though, is in neutral ice, and it's with Ruber. Ruber into the right wing corner to Petrov. Two goals for him, both of the Estonian markers in his column. Petrov side of the net, chance, Makarov, great save! Bounds, post to post, and punches clear.
Blocker save.
Makarov caught absolutely all of that, and somehow Ben Bounds, his lateral movement, outstanding. Wants the pass across the crease, goes to Lasalu. Now Makarov across the crease himself. Didn't miss by much. Petrov didn't have his stick on the ice, so he couldn't finish. He does, though, have possession. Now Makarov scores the equalising goal on the power play. You knew it was coming. And Great Britain have been bitten in the backside here. And Estonia are back on level terms for the first time since the first 26 seconds of this game. Makarov scores. It's 3-3.
Well, every single play and every single power play that they've had has been it's a picture by picture, same move by same move, looking for exactly the same setup. It's like Ruber, Petchkov, Matkov.
Myers gets it back to Weaver. Dead center on the blue line. Dowd will walk in, snaps it, scores! He wins the game! And Great Britain sneak through with a 4-3 overtime victory over Estonia. And once again, it's that man, Robert Dowd.
Well, we've got the win. Dowdy, first shift on overtime. Lots of space out there. Weaver drawing the guy, makes the pass across to Dowd. And wrist shot. Goal, 2 points in the bag, and there was 1:38 remaining in overtime there, and just I'm pretty pleased myself that game's over, and hopefully that's the, if you want to label it or name it as the, not the best one to see so far.
Yes.
Well, Pete, that was, you like sometimes put the fans through it, that was exciting.
It was ugly, but there's always going to be games you can lose. you know, we played really well yesterday. Today we got away from a little bit, but they're a different type of team to play against, a different structure, maybe not a lot of structure, but you know what, it's 2 points. You win another 3 games, you don't care, so we just got to get to the next game now and try and do the same again, get more points to the ball.
When all said and done, do you mind the performance wasn't great, or will you go back and analyse that and analyse what you can improve?
You know, there's a lot of pressure on them now, and they know that, and they're trying to, you know, we showed a bit of character there because we're struggling for a while, and we came strong the last 5, so it's good, we get on with it.
That's what's good about this side, isn't it? We showed that last year, the side did, GB, they've got the character to kind of pull together in downtime.
Yeah, but you know what, we never really got going, I don't think, and sometimes things happen, but you know what, we got the 2 points, that's the main thing.
I think Chris Ellis has somebody with him. Chris, who have you got?
Yeah, I'm joined by Robert Farmer. Robert Farmer, how was that game to play? And you, it was hard work, but you found a way, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, they're a pretty good team, and I don't think we played exactly how we wanted it, particularly the first 2 periods. But at the end of the day, we got the win, and yeah, that's all that counts.
Is it sometimes hard to? It was so good last night. Is it hard to kind of find it again so soon?
I don't think it's hard, but I think you're playing against a different style of team every single day, and yeah, I don't think we played how we wanted to today, to be honest. But like I said, we got the win, and our assignment for the rest of the week doesn't change now, and we're happy about that.
Okay, well done. That's Robert Farmer, and now joined by Robert Dowd. Robert, congratulations! You have a knack of scoring the big goals. Is this the sort of situation you thrive on?
Yeah, I mean it's always great to score those goals. I like being put in those situations, but we got to go back to it. It's a team effort. Like we played a good game. It didn't go the way we wanted it to go, but we stuck with it, and we got the result.
Do you see it as a good 2 points, or do you maybe see it as a point that's maybe lost? How do you assess that?
Well, we got the 2 points. We wanted 3, but we got 2. We'll take 2, but we don't go into these games hoping for 2 points. We want to win out at this thing, and we want to really go out for it. So it's disappointing to drop that 1 point, but all we got to do is take care of all of our games, and we won't have that issue.
Estonia are much improved, aren't they, from last year?
Yeah, I think their defensive side of the game was very good today. They trapped up the middle very well and made life difficult for us. And they took a couple of chances when they got them, so you got to hand it to them. But we got the result we wanted in the end.
I guess the good thing is that you've won 2 out of 2 now, 5 points from 6. But you know you can do more. That's good signs for a tournament.
Absolutely. I mean, the group of guys we got in there, we strive for better things every day. We try and get better every day. And like I said, that's a point that we didn't want to drop, but if we take care of what's in front of us, then we don't have to worry about it.
Just before I let you go, how do you go into rest day? Is it a case of probably a shorter skate and just resting bodies, or do you think Pete maybe might put you through your paces?
No, I think it'll be a rest day. We played a lot of ice hockey in the last week or two, and there's a few bodies starting to lag a little bit. You're starting to feel it in your legs. It's a lot of hockey. You're playing a short amount of time, so I think it'll be a shorter practice tomorrow, a few walkthroughs in there. Lots of rest.
GB were made to work for that victory. It wasn't pretty, but sometimes games just aren't at international level. The main thing was, in terms of this competition, they got the 2 points. And Seth Bennett commentated on the game for BBC 5 Live Sports Extra. Would GB be content speaking after the game to the personnel? They were knowing they'd done things wrong, but they got the win. How did you see the game?
I don't think they'll be content with the performance. You know, they were a long way away from what they'd set themselves 24 hours earlier with the performance against Croatia. They were nowhere near as good. However, a win's a win. And they were put in a situation where they had to fight back. And at 3-3, they could have folded. They didn't. They went into overtime. And lo and behold, the speed of Evan Mosey gets them a power play. And then the clinical finishing of Robert Dowd again, delivering in the clutch for Great Britain. He's having a really, really good tournament.
That was a really interesting decision from Pete to put Evan Mosey on the back end suddenly in overtime, because his speed more than once opened up Estonia, didn't it?
Well, I think that's exactly what he does in Nottingham, isn't it? It's how Corey Nielsen uses him. So it's smart thinking. You can use Mosey, and if Mosey has a zone of speed on you, well, good luck to you. If you're a forward or a defenseman, you're trying to go from a standing start or a pivot start, what are you going to do? I mean, he's going to blow right back by you. That's exactly what happened. Makarov put his stick on him, gets the penalty, even though the puck never got anywhere close to him, gets the interference call, and then all of a sudden Great Britain have the chance to prosper on the 4-on-3, which is exactly what they did.
Now, Russ Cowley scored 2 goals in an international game for the first time in his career. He's now got 3 goals in this tournament. What is it with Russ Cowley at the moment and international hockey? Didn't he get 2 in Italy as well?
He's playing really, really well. He's got 6 goals in his last 15 internationals. These are all internationals that came after his retirement. So you realise that he's just hit a golden seam in his career where he knows his role. He understands what he should be doing. He's playing with players that bring a lot out of him. Last year in Eindhoven, he was playing alongside Matt Haywood, I think, and also alongside Jonathan Phillips. Now he's playing alongside Ashley Tate. He's found a line mate in Craig Peacock, who again is another player that has just added to his game. And he's got that scoring touch. The goal, his second goal, the pass from Ashley Tate was wonderful. Great bit of play. It shows what he brings to the team. But you know, it's another 3 points in the bag for Russ Cowley. And he really is playing his best hockey of his career, in my opinion.
Now, there was a gentleman I heard you praising throughout the game, Jonathan Boxall. You were talking about his face-off stats, weren't you?
Yeah, Great Britain through two periods found themselves having lost 15 more face-offs than their opposition Estonia in this game. They just couldn't get puck possession. The only guy who was a positive was Jonathan Boxall. And that's one of the things that he brings to the game. We saw him in practice the other day, working really hard with Chuck Weber, who's using the back end of his stick, using the butt end to get his hand-eye coordination going. He sees that as being a key role on the team. And as the game wore on, Pete Russell, every key face-off, Boxall, Boxall, Boxall. It meant at times he was double-shifting, but he had to get out there. He had to go and try and win possession, which he did. And even in overtime, again, first player he looked to, get Jonathan Boxall out there, offensive zone, defensive zone, he's winning the face-offs. He's been a crucial cog in the GB wheel, and that's because he just works plumbing hard at it. He's not the biggest, he's not the strongest, but he's just found himself this role at centre where now all of a sudden he's become a key player.
Apologies for the musical interruptions. It's not Seth's favourite tunes on a ghetto blaster.
Yeah, it's my phone.
Yeah, there's a game going on at the moment as we do this. It's Croatia-Ukraine. And that kind of brings me on to this next point. What does this result do now for GB's chances? How does the tournament, do you think, open up or not so much open up for
them? It doesn't change a thing for me. GB need 5 wins.
To be able, from the start. Yeah,
if you want to win it, you've got to win all 5 games. Okay, after that, you're relying on other people. Don't do that. Great Britain still have it well within their own hands. You know, is it going to get as far as going to that big game against Ukraine, as everybody's talked about before? Well, maybe it will. But Lithuania have won their last 2 meetings with Great Britain. Last year, Great Britain only needed a point. Last year, Great Britain had 3 5-on-3 power plays. They took care of one of them. You know, it's a hard game. Lithuania are a tight-knit group. They're playing some pretty good hockey right now. They've won their first 2 games. They're here for a gold medal. They've got a rest day, and they're going to be plotting how they're going to be able to beat Great Britain. So we can't look at Ukraine just yet. But to me, winning overtime, winning regulation, once, it doesn't matter. I think then if you get to a position where you've dropped 2 points, well, then it starts to make a bit of a difference, because it could mean another team could gazump you, only needing 1 point from their final game, as the situation Great Britain was in against against Lithuania 12 months ago. And that's the last thing you want, knowing that Ukraine maybe just need overtime in that last game. From a Great Britain perspective, they could then go off and win the gold medal. You could win the game and still go home with silver. You don't want that.
Okay, that's Seth Bennett, who commentated on the game for BBC Radio 5 Live Sports Extra. We'll be with you again before the next game, but just a reminder, that is on Wednesday. It's called a rest day tomorrow. There will be some sort of skate. How hard it will be, I don't think it will be too strenuous, but I'm sure the coaching staff will make that in the next few hours. But GB then will be back in action on Wednesday. It's at 4:30 local time, 3:30 in the UK. Much more to come, but for now, thanks for joining us on Ice Hockey UK TV in association with McDonald's.